Reduce each radical on the right. Drag the correct reduced radical to each radical expression. So look at radical 175. And what we want to do is we want to find out what all the factors are that multiply to make 175, and then we can go ahead and see if we can reduce the radical. So I know a 5 goes into 175 because the number ends in 5, but the question is how many times? Well, I'm not sure, so I'm going to divide it out. So 5 goes into 17 3 times, 3 times 5 is 15, 25, 5, 25, 0. Remember long division? Good times. So 35 here, and let's see. Continue with the upside down division. 5 goes in again, and that goes in 7 times. So you have 7, 5, 5. So that equals radical of 7 times 5 times 5. You can only take out the pairs. This is the same thing as radical of 7 times radical of 25, really. And that's equal to 5 radical 7. So this one matches to 5 radical 7. Radical 200, I know that one. That's 10 times 10 times 2. Because 10 times 10 is 100, and then times 2 makes 200. And I can take out the pair of 10s, so that's going to be equal to 10 radical 2. Radical 180, let's see, that's 18 times 10. But 18 times 10, that's not perfect squares. How about if we write it out as radical of 9 times 2 times 5 times 2, because 9 times 2 is 18, 5 times 2 is 10. So we got a pair of 2's here that can come out, and also this 9 is a perfect square. So you can take out a 3 and a 2. So that's 3 times 2 on the outside, and then the 5 is the only thing left over. So it's going to be 6 radical 5. Then radical 135, I know a 5 divides in evenly because the number ends in 5. So it goes into 10 twice. 35, 7, 7 times 5, 35, 0. So I'm going to get 27 here, and then a 3, and then a 9. So this is 9 times 3 times 5. And the 9 is a perfect square, so I can take that out, and square root of 9 is 3, so I get a 3 on the outside, and then 15 on the inside, so it's 3 square root 15. Like that. Okay, so I showed you a couple different ways to reduce radicals. One way is upside down division, like we did with the first problem and the last problem, and another way is to try and factor out the perfect squares if you have a pair of them, like with this 200 had a pair of 10s, so we could take one of those out. And 180, that was kind of like a hybrid. So I knew that it was 18 times 10, so I just factored a little more from there and then was able to figure out that the 9 was a perfect square, and then the 2 times 2, that's another factor pair that could come out. So I took out the 3 times 2.